easy go. So deal the cards and on with the show on Card Sharks. And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Perry.
Thank you very much. I thank you. And welcome to Card Sharks. You're very kind. And also being very kind, taking part in the show, sending in an opening poem, Eric Schneider of Scotia, New York. Thank you, Eric. And now, let's get to the cards. Gaddis and Bettine, if you will, start loading in two brand new decks of cards. It will meet today's card sharks. Judy Campbell. Hello, Judy. Nice to see you again.
Good morning. It's nice to see you again.
Won't you remind us about yourself?
Well, my name is Judy Campbell, and I'm living in Newport Beach, but I'm originally from Cleveland, Ohio. I've been married 1 year to my teenage sweetheart that I hadn't seen for 22 years.
Oh, isn't that nice? And you've done very well here. You have won $6,200 in cash.
Beautiful.
Judy, you're a good champion. We're meeting our challenger for the first time, Dave Barella. Is it Dave?
Barella.
Dave, nice to have you here with us. Why don't you tell us about yourself?
Well, my name is Dave Barella. I'm born and bred Southern Californian. I live in Whittier. I'm in my last year of law school.
Is that the family, Dave?
No. I'm in my last year of law school, and I'm in the finishing stages of recording a demo album. Hopefully.
Terrific. And singing or playing or what?
Both, really. I play guitar and I sing.
Well, I wish you well with it. You can always negotiate your own contracts, Dave,
right?
Oh, I hope
so. Right.
Good to have you here. Good luck to both of you.
Thank you.
And the cards have been shuffled. The players cut the cards. Judy, the champion, plays the upper cards, the red deck. Dave, the challenger, plays the lower cards, the blue deck. We play the best two games out of three. And we'll start off with a question to you, Judy.
Okay.
Judy, we asked 100 bachelors, if a girl you were dating really wanted a baby and she promised there would be no strings attached, would you help her get her wish? How many bachelors said they would help?
No, I don't think there's any bachelors want to be. If they're bachelors, they don't want to be tied down right now with any kind of responsibility.
No, she said no strings attached.
Even if there were no strings, I think they would still say no way. That's going to be a low figure of about 15.
15 bachelors with no strings attached. What do you think?
Well, That's a great explanation, and that's a great number. It's definitely going to be low. Basically, the same reasons. Guys just don't want any strings attached. I'm going to play a little bit safer, and I'm going to say a little bit lower.
Even lower
it's
than that?
It's got to be lower. It's
well, if it is lower, Dave, you'll get to play your cards first. If not, it'll be Judy. Now, let's find out. The actual number of bachelors who would help their girlfriend get her wish is 27. It is not lower. Judy. And Judy starts off with...
That's bad card. Please change that card. Please.
Whenever you win the question, you have the right to change it to a two.
Great. Great. The next card's higher.
Higher than a two. Yes, a queen.
Lower.
Lower than a queen. A two.
Oh, great. The next card's got to be higher.
Higher than a two. A five.
Oh, dear. I'm freeze.
You're freeze.
I'm freeze right there.
We move over the freeze bar. Judy playing a little conservative. She doesn't want to lose those cards, and now she cannot lose them. She needs one for the first game of the match. Dave, we surveyed 100 prison inmates at Folsom State Prison, and we asked them, since you've been in prison, have you smoked marijuana? Don't they know they can get arrested for that?
Oh.
No. How many inmates said that they have smoked marijuana in prison?
Well, that's a difficult question. But, you know, in the paper, you always read how, dope is being smuggled in prison and this and that. So I'm going to say it would be fairly high, possibly 30.
30 inmates have smoked marijuana.
There's so much going on in the prisons. It's got to be a lot higher than that. Higher.
Even higher?
Yes.
Well, the actual number of inmates who've smoked marijuana in prison is 47. Judy, you're right, it is higher. We left off with a five, Judy.
I know, but I'm going to change that five and hope for a really good card.
You're going to change it.
Really
you won
good.
The question, and it becomes
an
eight.
No.
You are right up the middle.
Right up the middle. Okay, I'm going to say it's lower.
Lower. If this is lower, Judy has the first game
there.
Of the match. If not, Dave is still
lower.
In it for the win. Yes, it is lower. Judy wins game one with a seven. And $100. Game two will be coming up. Our challenger tries to make a comeback right after this commercial break. And we're back with game Carolina setting up for game two. Same two decks of cards. These are the next cards off the top of the deck. And as we left off, game two starts with a question to you, Judy.
Okay.
We asked 100 women, if you had to choose just one, would you rather kiss or hug? How many women said they would rather hug?
Oh, no. Well, being a woman, and I love kissing better than I do hugging, I'd have to say, if a woman would rather... How many would rather hug than kiss? Not very many. I think more would rather kiss. I'm going to say it's going to be low, about at least low figure, like 25.
25 would rather hug than kiss, Dave. What do you think?
I'm going to have to disagree with that. Personal experience, I think girls definitely like to feel close. They love to hug. I don't really think that they're that interested in the kissing, though they both go together quite well. I'm definitely
yes, there is
say,
a definite relationship,
wow.
Dave. Yeah,
it's got to be higher.
Higher.
It's got to be higher.
From personal experience, Dave says higher. The actual number of women who would rather hug is 32. You're right, Dave. It is higher.
Great. Great.
Janice, which do you prefer, hugging or kissing? You like them both together. Okay. Dave, you're starting with an 8.
Okay, I'm going to change that card.
Changing the 8 to a 10.
Ooh.
A little better.
Okay, it's not the greatest card, but I'm going to say lower. It's got to be
10.
Lower.
It is
great,
a 4.
Great, great. Okay. Come on, Lady Luck. Give me a higher card. Higher.
Higher than a 4.
Great.
That's a king.
I'm rolling now. Okay, it's got to be lower. It's got to be lower.
Lower than a king? No. It is not, and you lose all three cards back to the base card. You couldn't talk it through.
No.
Judy, you have a 7.
And I can't change it.
No, you did not win the question. You cannot change it.
Let's just say it's going to be higher.
Higher than a 7.
Oh,
no, it's a 5.
I knew that.
Couldn't take advantage of it. Janice will fill in the spaces. And Dave, the question to you. Dave, we asked 100 people, very simply, do you agree with President Carter's decision to free Patty Hearst from prison? How many people said they do agree with the president's decision?
Oh, boy, that's going to be a tough one. I imagine it's definitely pro and con.
It is definitely pro and con, Dave. You're going to make a good lawyer, Dave.
Let's hope so.
How many agree with the president's decision?
Okay, I'm going to stay right in the middle. I'm going to say it's 50.
50.
Either way.
That's pro and con, Judy. What do you think?
The middle. That's hard. I had heard a lot of people wanted her freed, but when she got freed, they said they didn't want her freed. I'm going to say it's going to be a little bit lower.
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 The actual number of people who agree with the president's decision to free Patty Hearst is 68. Not lower. You got it, Dave. 68. Interesting answer on that.
Okay.
You have a 10, Dave.
I'm going to change that.
Here we go. He's talking himself into it now. Changing the 10 to another 10.
I'm so much shocked. Okay, I'm going to say lower.
Lower than a 10. It
great,
is a 3.
Great. Okay. It's got to be higher. It's got to be higher.
Higher than a 3.
Great.
Yes, a 9.
I better play safe. I'm going to freeze.
You're going to freeze.
I'm going to freeze.
Taking that 2-card advantage. The audience agrees with that decision. Judy, we asked 100 fifth grade boys in Pennsylvania. If you were a policeman, fifth grade boys, if you were a policeman and the driver you stopped for speeding turned out to be your father, would you give him a ticket? How many fifth grade boys said they would give daddy a ticket?
Well, being a fifth grader, and if they had to give daddy a ticket, they might be a little bit afraid, but I think they would think ahead and think, no, sir, I'm a policeman, and daddy did wrong, he's going to get a ticket. I say it's going to be at least 60.
60 fifth graders would give daddy a ticket if they were a policeman.
Well, boy, that was beautiful. I'm going to say...
She sold you on
that one. Yeah, she sure did. I should hire her. That's got to be lower. She picked a... too high of an answer for my liking. It's got to be lower. It's got to be lower.
The actual number of fifth grade boys who would give their own father a ticket is 68, not lower. And you got it, Judy.
Okay, nicely I'll change done. That 7.
Now you can change the 7. Judy changes it to 8. Ooh.
That's right. Next card's got to be higher this time.
Higher than an 8. It is a 10.
Good. Lower. Lower than...
risking it. Lower than a 10. It is a 9.
I'm gonna freeze. Right there.
We've got a tie now.
Yes.
Each player needs 2 cards, and we are at sudden death. Someone has to win with the next play of the card, so control of the board, very important. Dave, we found 100 married women who have full-time jobs, and we asked them, when your boss yells at you, do you take it out on your husband? How many working women admitted they do take it out on their husband?
Well, I'm going to say that's very high. I know when I've gone out on a few dates that I've been somewhat yelled at, and I really didn't know why, and then I found out they had a bad day at work. So I'm going to say about 60.
60
on the nose.
60. Judy, what do you think?
No.
60 said they take it out on their husband.
They might if they saw their husband right away after work, but they've got to drive home. And on the way home, they're going to chew it up. And I think it's going to be lower than that.
So that's the reason for lower. The actual number of working wives who take it out on their husband when their boss yells at them is 21. Judy, you're right. It is lower. Judy, we're in sudden death. You have a 9. You need 2 cards. Dave also has a 9. He needs 2 cards, but you've got control of that board. Do you want to play it or pass it, Judy?
I'm going to pass it to Dave.
All right, Dave, if you can turn both these cards over, you have tied up the match. But if you make one mistake, Judy wins the game and the match with a 9. Call this.
Okay. I don't see any face cards up there. I think we're due for a face card. I hope it's true. Give me higher.
Higher than a 9. No, it is not higher than a 9, and Judy wins it in sudden death. Dave, you took a chance going against the odds there, looking for the face card. We wish you good luck with your singing and your playing and your long career. You're a nice gentleman. Thank you for joining us. Dave Borrella, Judy, come on down here. You can't believe it. You're doing it so well. Judy's up over $6,000, $6,400 to be exact. Going for the big money right after this commercial break. Clear it up this time.